गॉट, मिल गया।
आप कर रहे कर रहो लगते हो आप
कागज पत्र का हिसाब देख रहे हैं।
तो टुडे टॉपिक इज पार्वोविरिडी एंड द एज यू ऑल नो पार्वोविरिडी इज अ वायरस ग्रुप एंड इट्स अ फैमिली ऑफ द वायरस विच बिलोंग्स टू डीएनए वायरस। द टर्म पार्वस इज टेकन फ्रॉम द लैटिन वर्ड विच मीन्स स्मॉल एंड this virus is a causative agent for the many virus important diseases and it is having two sub families parvovirini and densovirini. Parvovirini it's a sub family in which viruses of vertebrates are there and a total of 8 genera are present. In densovirini viruses of insect and other invertebrates are there. These are the small DNA viruses and genome is single stranded, linear, positive sense and negative sense. Normally the virus DNA structure is what is it is double stranded structure. And in this single stranded DNA is there, one strand is positive strand or sense strand and another strand is negative sense strand. So some viruses in some viruses, negative strand goes, and in some viruses, positive strand of the virus goes. So some viruses is having positive sense of genome, and some is having negative sense. And this is having icosahedral symmetry and composed of 60 subunits. Virus is non-enveloped, and virus is non-enveloped virus, so it is somewhat resistant, and it is resistant to lipid solvent, and pH range is of 3 to 9, and heating up to 56 degrees centigrade for the 60 minutes, it can withstand, but it can be inactivated by formalin, beta propiolactone, sodium hypochlorite, but it remains viable in fomites for the long time. And site of the replication is nucleus. Already told in, during the time study of the replication. And the infection leads to formation of large intranuclear inclusion bodies. And it also having a heme agglutinating activities. This property should be remembered because very few viruses are having properties of heme agglutination. And in this group also, except the Aleutian mink disease virus and Buch parvoviruses, all are having heme agglutination activity. And this property is used for its identification. It is having a total of 8 genera, and the most of the pathogenic animal parvoviruses are included in protoparvovirus. And these viruses are shed in feces in large quantities. It requires mitotically active cells for replication, and some parvoviruses show tropism for rapidly dividing cells. Hemopoietic cells, lymphocytes, or epithelium cells of intestinal mucosa are rapidly dividing cells. So these viruses have tropism for these systems, and they affect these systems. And during the early age, mitotically active cells are present in a large quantity. So age-dependent susceptibility is also there in parvoviruses. Means the in the early age of the animal, they are more susceptible for the parvovirus infections. There are in the subfamily Parvovirini, there are 8 genera. These are Amdoparvovirus, Aviparvovirus, Boca parvovirus, Copiparvovirus, डिपेंडोपारोवायरस, इरिथ्रोपारोवायरस, प्रोटोपारोवायरस एंड टेट्रापारोवायरस. डिपेंडोपारोवायरस अर्लियर इट वॉज नोन एज डिपेंडोवायरस एंड इट इंक्लूडेड ओनली एडिनो एसोसिएटेड वायरस एंड विच नीड्स द हेल्प ऑफ एडिनो वायरस फॉर द रेप्लिकेशन. बट नाउ इट ऑल्सो इंक्लूड्स बूज पारोवायरस. These are the important genus which includes the viruses of the veterinary importance, and them these are protoparvovirus, which is a major group of the subfamily Parvovirini, and it includes the viruses feline panleukopenia virus, mink enteritis virus, canine parvovirus, porcine parvovirus, parvovirus of the rodents, and rabbit parvovirus. Amblyoparvovirus is, it includes Aleutian mink disease virus, and aviparvovirus, it includes chicken and turkey parvovirus. Boca parvovirus, bovine or ca for canine. Boca parvovirus, bovine parvovirus, and canine parvovirus serotype 1. Which is also known as canine minute virus. And dependoparvovirus, it includes Boogie parvovirus and duck parvovirus. And apart from these, dependoparvovirus includes adeno-associated viruses. So these are the important parvoviruses of the Parvovirini family. Some of the important diseases of the veterinary significance are bovine parvovirus, which causes diarrhea in calves, or it is non-significant. Canine parvovirus 1 is also minor diseases. It causes subclinical enteric infection in dogs. Mink enteritis virus, it causes disease generalized as the panleukopenia virus, which is in the mink. Boogie parvovirus, it is highly contagious and causes fatal disease of the boogling. Aleutian mink virus, it causes chronic and progressive disease, and in disease is persistent, having persistent viremia and characterized as immune complex related lesions. Porcine parvovirus, it causes important disease related to reproductions, reproductive systems, and in short, it is called as SMEDI. This should be learned. You have to remember this: SMEDI, stillbirth, mummification, embryonic death, and infertility. Feline panleukopenia is an important disease of cats, and it causes panleukopenia and enteritis. Canine parvovirus 2. Means it is caused by serotype 2, and it is an important disease of dogs, and it causes enteritis and panleukopenia like syndrome. And earlier it was very much known for myocarditis in pups, but now it is a rare infection. So coming to the disease in detail, feline panleukopenia, as I told, it is an important disease of feline, and it is caused by feline parvovirus, and it is also known as feline infectious enteritis or feline distemper. It is a disease. It is a disease commonly seen in young or recently weaned kittens. And for this disease, fleas and human may act as a mechanical vector. Means mechanical vector means disease. They are not infected. Just they transmit disease to the cats. And disease is mainly through the ingestion or inhalation. And replication occurs mainly in lymphoid tissue of the oropharynx and associated lymph nodes, and it causes destruction of the cells of intestinal crypts and lymphocytic cells of bone marrow, thymus, lymph nodes and spleen. And due to the destruction of the lymphoid tissue, it results in panleukopenia, and as it also infects intestinal crypts, it results in villous atrophy of the intestine. So related symptoms of these organs are seen, and disease is of subclinical, subacute or severe disease. Incubation period for the disease is 4 to 5 days, and subclinical infection is characterized by mild fever and leukopenia, which is a common infection, and usually it is followed by the lifelong immunity. Subacute disease, it is characterized by depression, fever and diarrhea, which lasts for the 1 to 3 days. And severe disease is also caused, and it is mostly seen in unvaccinated cat in the age group of the 6 to 24 weeks of the age. Severe disease is characterized by pronounced depression, anorexia, fever, vomiting, and sometimes it is accompanied by diarrhea or dysentery. And if diarrhea and dysentery occurs, it results in severe dehydration and electrolyte imbalance and abdominal pain. Disease is followed by the subnormal temperature, and it is also followed by death within 24 hours. And mortality for this type of disease ranges from 25% to 90%, and the survived cats is having long-lasting immunity. If pregnant cats get infection, in two stages, either in the early gestation age or in the late pregnancy time. If infection occurs in the early gestation, it may result in reabsorption or abortion. And during the late pregnancy infection occurs, then it may result in stillbirth or early neonatal death. Survived kittens may have teratological changes, means they have abnormal fetal growth or development, and which results in cerebellar hypoplasia or retinal dysplasia. Cerebellar hypoplasia means his cerebellum is smaller than development is not proper. Retinal dysplasia means it's a eye disease in which round clumps are present in the retinal tissue. So if the kitten is having cerebellar hypoplasia, then it will show the symptoms of cerebellar ataxia, exhibited as incoordination and tremors, and these symptoms will persist for the life. These are not going to be healed. So how to diagnose the disease? If animal owner presents the cat with the history of no vaccination and having the diarrhea, then this disease may be suspected. And if WBC count is done, then it will be having low WBC count. Virus can be demonstrated in fecal sample by electron microscopy. Viral antigen can also be detected in feces using ELISA. HI test can be done using pig or rhesus monkey RBC. Virus neutralization test can be done, or PCR can be used for the disease diagnosis. Treatment and control. As it is a viral disease, there is no proper treatment. Only supportive treatment, intensive supportive treatment can be used, which includes fluid therapy, whole blood or plasma from the immune donor. Broad spectrum antibiotics can be used to inhibit the secondary bacterial infections. And diet can be supplemented with B complex. there is vaccine available as a modified live and inactivated vaccines, and which is practiced in cat rearing, and it also need disinfection of the premises with 1% hypochlorite or 2% formalin. Canine parvovirus, it occurs mainly through the serotype 2, canine parvovirus 2, and it is acute enteric diseases of young dogs, which affect mainly between the age of weaning and 6 months of the age. And it is considered as a host range mutant of the feline panleukopenia virus. Means the same type of disease is caused and same type of the virus nature is there, but it occurs in dogs instead of cats. Transmission is mainly due by fecal oral route, and the severity and the form of the disease depends upon the age and the age immune status of the animal. Pathogenesis, viral replicates as seen in feline panleukopenia virus. It also replicates in the pharyngeal lymphoid tissue and Peyer's patches, and viremia develops. Rapidly dividing the cell population are the main target, and during the first 2 weeks of the age, cardiac myocytes division rapidly occurs, and so it becomes a site for the virus replication, and if that time virus infection occurs, it results in necrosis and myocarditis of the kittens. In older pups, it invades the actively dividing cells of the epithelium of the crypts of the small intestine, and it results in the blunting of the villi and causes reduced absorptive and digestive capacity of the intestine, leading to the diarrhea. Extensive hemorrhage of the intestinal lumen is also seen in affected pigs, pups, and destruction of lymphoid tissue of the intestinal mucosa and mesenteric lymph nodes leads to immunosuppression. And due to the damaged intestine, secondary bacterial infection may occur, or it may lead to the endotoxemia or endotoxic shock. What will be the clinical signs? In enteric disease, incubation period is 4 to 7 days, and it results in sudden onset of vomiting and anorexia. Depression and fever may be observed. Diarrhea, often blood stain is seen, and in severe cases, frank hemorrhage, means the blood will be totally reddish and full of hemorrhage. Feces will be having fetid smell, dehydration and weight loss will be seen, and severely affected animal die within 3 days. Survived animal will have long lasting immunity, and in myocardial form, which is now a rare condition, results from the infection in the first week of the life. Parvovirus infection of the myocardium results due to the rapid proliferation of the myocytes in the first week of the life, and usually manifested as acute heart failure and sudden death in pups. And the pups which survive this acute myocardial injury may develop cardiomyopathy, means a chronic heart problem they will develop, and which may lead to cardiac failure. Now it is a rare infection, as there is immunity in the breeding bitches, which protects almost all puppies during the susceptible period. Because when this virus was new and no vaccination was done, this form of the disease was very common. Now vaccination is practiced, so this form is now a rare condition. Diagnosis. Sudden onset of the foul-smelling bloody diarrhea in young dogs is suggestive of the parvoviral infection. Disease can be diagnosed by hemagglutination of the pig, cat, and rhesus monkey red blood cells by virus in the fecal extract. Immunocytochemical staining can be done for the viral antigen detection in the tissues, And inclusion bodies, presence of inclusion bodies in cardiac myocytes is confirmatory. Electron microscopy can be done to detect the virus particle in the fecal sample. ELISA can be used. PCR can be done. And virus isolation can be attempted in canine and feline cell lines. In canine A72 cells, Crandall feline kidney cells. Coming to the treatment, there is no specific treatment available. And it requires intensive supportive treatment, which includes antiemetic and fluid administration, broad spectrum antibiotics for the secondary bacterial infections,